In the Planting FX Revit plugin, we've got hundreds of families set up and ready for you to place and quickly assign plant data. If you're new to Revit, a family is the term for a grouping of symbols that makes up the tree and shrub symbols for 2D and 3D views. If you select an already placed Planting FX family, you'll notice that the parameters are there, but locked. We've simplified the parameter process for plant families and moved it to the Edit Plant window, where you can control the available options for your office through the plant preferences. Let's explore how this works. After you add a tree or shrub to the plant manager, you can select the species and click Edit. This will open up the plant info window. Everything in here is editable, even the names and codes, and will only affect the information for plants in this Planting FX project, without changing anything in the master plant database or in other projects' plant lists. All of these sections link to the parameters we saw before, but they can't read in changes to the parameters made in the properties palette. That's why they were locked in the properties palette. For the size fields, the options here are directly linked to the plant sizes preferences and can be changed there for all Planting FX users in your office using the same preference set. These are the default sizes in our default Imperial preference set. And our default metric preference set. But again, you can customize this list to the options available in your area and use up to 6 slots for even more information, like WUCLs in California, a native yes-no column, or anything else you need. These fields become columns in your plant schedule. Then you can set a family symbol to this plant code. Each of these 2D symbols are connected to a 3D billboard symbol in the same family file, and they'll scale together using the symbol spread option in Plant Info. You must choose a unique family for each plant. Click OK to save the changes. This is also the way to edit those parameters on already placed plants. You'll see the changes to the size is updated. You're free to add the same species multiple times to the plant manager, using different codes and different families. This strategy is great when you need to document different sizes of the same species, like you would in a restoration planting design. The best part about this method of editing plants is that I can now import plants already set up from different projects and create them as a copy in this project. You can use the Import button instead of the New button for this. I'll just edit this plant that I imported, and you can see it's already filled in and ready to place. Finally, use the Edit Plant tool from the ribbon to simply select a plant in the plan in 2D or 3D view and change anything you want about it, using your company standards. Using the Planting FX Revit plugin, you'll be fine-tuning your planting design in Revit faster than you ever have before.